everyone, my name is Hannah-Marie and I'm a first year medical student at Brighton and Sussex Medical School. So today is a Wednesday and I'm starting my week in the life today because yesterday and Monday were pretty hectic, but they were a lot of fun, so I'll still tell you what I did anyway. But today's plan is that I have a meeting with my academic tutor at 11:45 to discuss my essay. So I'm going to look over the notes that she wrote on it because I submitted it a couple of weeks ago now. So I've got my marks back to see what I can improve on for next time. The teachers here are really good at giving feedback and they really give you a good direction to go with it as well. So I've got to do that. I did a workout as soon as I woke up this morning with my flatmate in the kitchen, which was a lot of fun. It's always nice to have a little workout buddy. And I think I'm also going to do a lecture as well before my talk. So yeah, that should be fun. Hi again. So I've just had my talk with my academic tutor and it went really well. I didn't really have any points to pick up on other than referencing, and that was a big step up coming because I came straight from sick form to uni and I've written one academic essay before, so this was quite a challenge, but we got a lot of help, so that's really good. Also discussed my oral presentation, which I had to do. So I did mine on whether you should use fetal or postnatal surgery to treat myelomeningocele, which is a congenital neurological and neurosurgical defect, which I'm really interested in at the minute. And that was really good as well. And yeah, so I'm currently doing a lecture on principles of the nervous system, which I really enjoy. I'm first year rep for NeuroSoc this year, it's a bit hard with COVID, but we're trying to get some events running to encourage particularly first years to get involved in like neurology and neurosurgery and make it more accessible, which I'm really excited about. So I'm going to do this lecture, then I think I'm either going to have some lunch or do some more revision because I have a mock test to do, because we have our knowledge test, which is like our end of term exam, in 2 weeks time actually. And so we have a mock one online just to figure out how to use the system. So I'll see you in a bit. So for lunch today, just got some spaghetti on toast with some spinach. Going to watch a little bit of The Crown. Hi guys, so it's been quite a while. I think I last left off at lunchtime, so since then I've done the exam online. I had a Teams meeting about the sociology and psychology module that we do, which was really good. We went through some case studies and I have made some bread cake thing. Doesn't look too appealing just now, but we're going to let it rise and I'm going to the library, so hopefully when I get back, I can cook it. So I have to admit my sleep schedule hasn't been great, but I'm going to try and get an early night tonight because I have a lot planned for tomorrow. But I'll catch you up a little bit more on what I did today. I had a space medicine talk, which was given by the Wilderness Medicine Society, BSMS, and that was really interesting. I mean, I don't really know much about space, but it was really cool anyway. Had dinner, obviously made my bread cake thingy. Usually my flatmates and I watch Bake Off, but I think they're at the library tonight. I'm really tired. I know I said at the start of this video that I was going to tell you what happened on Monday and Tuesday because they were fantastic days, but I didn't record them just because I was so exhausted. But on Monday we had a symposium, and so every Probably every week, maybe every 2 weeks, BSMS has these symposiums, which are basically like really long lectures. They're divided up into smaller ones, but usually they're based around a clinical scenario. So this week we had it on chronic lymphocytic leukemia, which was so interesting. I found it really fascinating. So we had a professor, a researcher in the area, we had a doctor who treats it. We also had a patient, so we got to ask him questions about living with the condition and how it really feels to be diagnosed with something like CLL. And so that was really, really interesting. And then Tuesdays are clinical days at BSMS, and you will see next Tuesday what I get up to. But yesterday I did particularly enjoy because it was my favourite strand. In the afternoons, we have separate strands you can do. And my favourite is inequalities and inclusion in healthcare. And so yesterday was really good in my opinion. And we did about gender inequalities within healthcare and then within the NHS as a whole. And I found it really, really, really interesting. And I'd highly recommend everyone just researching into biases within healthcare because it's a real eye-opener and it'll make you a better doctor and a better person in the long run.
Good morning. So it's Thursday, and I just wanted to show you a beautiful view outside of the window. So I'll show you outside this one as well. Look at those hills. So I'm going to do a bit of a workout with Evie, and then we'll get on with the day.
Hi, so I've just finished the module tutorial for our infection and immunology lectures. So that was on viruses, which I really love this module, but it's very complicated. So I'm going to do some revision for that now. Then I'm going to have some lunch, and then I have a meeting with the head of NeuroSoc to discuss one of my ideas for the society.
Hi, so again, it's been a bit of a while. It is now 5:30, so I had my NeuroSoc meeting, which was good. We're trying to organise a Christmas card scheme, and so I then contacted a care home about that, and then had a living anatomy session on Teams, which was very interesting. So we got to see how the ultrasound machines work, see what happens like when you take your pulse and then what it actually looks like on the machine, which was really, really interesting. Since then, I did a bit of online shopping, which I needed to do, had some lunch, and now I'm just writing some birthday cards for my friends from home. And I also need to do a lecture before dinner, so it's been quite a chill afternoon, but I had a very hectic morning, so it works out okay. Hi, so I thought I'd better show you what I'm cooking for dinner because yesterday I only showed you my lunch and I can actually cook. So I haven't tried this before, but this is a Spanish tortilla that I'm trying. And yesterday I had a spinach dal that I'd made on Monday. So I didn't enjoy cooking when I first came to uni, but now I absolutely love it. So anyone can cook. Guys, so today for breakfast we've got some American style pancakes, and my flatmate let me borrow some caramel syrup and some chocolate powder, so these should be really tasty.
Hello, so I've had my breakfast, it was very nice. I also did my two lymphatic system lectures, which I needed to do, and now I'm doing information governance, which is when you first join the medical school, you have to do lots of online training to use like the special resources, and this is my last one to do, so fingers crossed I can get this done because it's not my favourite thing, but need to get it done and then I can get on with the rest of my day. Hi guys, so it's been a while. As you can probably see, it is dark outside. But I did the information governance and passed that, and then had some lunch. I did some revision of the lymphatic system, which is what I revised this morning. Well, I didn't revise it this morning. I did the lectures this morning, then I revised it, and then I went for a little walk because I hadn't been outside today. And now I'm doing some psychology revision, and then it'll be Christmas dinner cooking time, which I'm really excited for. And that is why I'm wearing my little wham Christmas jumper. Got some Christmassy makeup going on because we're doing Christmas today, because next week is really close to our Katie, so we're going to have all the fun tonight.
Here is our little Christmas dinner setup. We've got apple crumble just waiting to be cooked,
And we've got our veggie beef Wellington, the chicken, all of this. And so soon, it'll be Christmas dinner time.
So it is Saturday today. I woke up at 10 o'clock because I was up really late last night with my flatmates, and so just had a nice chill morning. I did some physiology revision. I'm still doing that. I'm going to do that for the rest of the day. I FaceTimed my friend from home, which was really, really nice. And I think I'm going to try and meet my friend later on as well, but the weather isn't looking too good at the minute. Like, it's really grey, so we'll have to see how that turns out. Hey guys, so it is now Monday and it's currently 10 o'clock, so I've just had an hour-long Q&A session for one of our Theme 3 symposiums that we had quite a few weeks back now, but that cleared up quite a few questions that we had, and now I'm doing a pathology in practice lecture, and then I'm going to do the mock KT. So I washed my hair this morning, so that's why it's wet, but I'm quite tired. But I'll speak to you later. Good morning. So it is now 10 o'clock. It is Tuesday. So at 10 past nine, I had a meeting with my clinical facilitator just to discuss how this term had gone. It's been really good. I've loved it. I can't believe that's my last session of this year. And then I've just written out a little, let's try and pick it up, to-do list of things I need to get done today. So first off, I need to do my washing, and then I need to start my revision again. But I've had a nice morning, did a little leg workout as well. I think with medical school, it's really hard to keep juggling stuff, but I find waking up earlier means I can get more done in the day because I don't function late at night. But yeah, it's just finding a good balance, and it takes a while, but you'll all get used to it. Hello! So, as you can see, I'm back at uni now. I've got a few new posters up, and it's the end of January now, so I've been back for just, this is my third week I'm going into. And so far I'm loving it. We're doing module 103, which is called Heart, Lungs and Blood. And in this module we have five different themes. So we have one which is anatomy. So we do anatomy of the entire thorax. You've got your heart, your lungs, everything else going on in there. Module two is blood, which is my favourite. I really enjoy it, which I wasn't really expecting as much because at secondary school in sick form wasn't really interested in like immunity and all of that, but I really enjoy blood. Number three, which is cardiovascular system, which is also really cool. You might have a few like cardiothoracic surgeons out there who want to be. And then four is lungs, which is also really cool. Really complicated, but luckily the professors and lecturers are so supportive here, and every week we have a little help session that you can go to and just ask any questions you have, and the lecturers reply so quickly as well to their emails, because I've had to email a couple of times just to clarify some things, and they sent me like research articles as well, which is so cool. I don't think you get that anywhere else. And then number five is lifestyle, which is also really nice. I really enjoyed module 102 last term with the theme four lectures as well, which were really good. And so yeah, it's nice to have some psychology as well, because I do think psychology is so important when you're studying medicine, because medicine is just applied science onto people, and you need to be able to understand people. And yeah, so I'll do a little recap. I thought it'd be a good idea just to do a little summation at the end. Summary, that's the right word, summary, at the end of this term and at the end of this video, because I know my vlog was a bit disjointed, and it's because honestly medical school is a lot of work. Anyone will tell you that, and if they don't, maybe they're not properly doing medical school right. Because yeah, everyone I know, we all go through parts where we struggle with the workload, particularly during COVID. But the school is, the uni is so supportive, and you have all your friends here as well. People in the older years are so willing to help. Reached out to my medic mums and grandma quite a few times now, and it's just such a nice community. I really enjoyed last term. First term was fab. I passed my KT, which was great. We loved that. And yeah, it was really good. And hopefully this term we've got even more fun things to come. So I've started doing my SSC, which is a student selected component, and it's where you get probably a list of about 20 different, I think they're 8 week long tasks that you can do. And so there are loads of different ones. There are ones about surgery, congenital heart disease in children, lots of like pharmacology, but also someone like Python, quite a few different philosophy ones. We've got creative writing, so there's music, there's a bit for everyone. And I chose Iron on Trial as my number one choice, and I actually got it, which I was really glad about. And so my module is, my SSC is a debate where we discuss whether iron is good for the body or if it's bad. And it's so good, it's so interesting. I didn't know iron did as much as it did. You can have a little research if you want to, because it's involved in like cancer, infection, neurodegeneration, but it's also used in like development and actually staying alive and healthy. So it's a really interesting module. I really like it. I like a debate as well. And so we have an SSC every term in year one, apart from the first term. So I've got another one next term, and then we've got three in year two as well. So I'm really excited. And they change for each module as well. So ours are more focused upon heart, lungs and blood, and next term they'll be more focused on endocrinology and nutrition, which will be really interesting. And aside from academics, this time should be really good. I mean, it's COVID, so everything's online at the minute, which isn't great, but you have to do it for everyone's safety. I'm sure everyone watching this right now, if you're watching in 2021, like, you'll all understand as well. And so I'm a part of SMUTS, which is the Sussex Musical Theatre Society, and we're going to be doing the showcase in spring, which I'm a part of. So I had a rehearsal last week on Zoom, which was really good fun. And also entered a debate competition with some BSMS students and some biomed students as well. And we actually got into the final, which is really cool. So that's in a few weeks' time. So it's honestly something for everyone here. Like, we're a small medical school, but it just means that we're close-knit and a real community. But it doesn't mean there's any less opportunities. Like, I would say there's more, to be honest. And obviously still trying to do stuff in neurosoc, and staying on top of all the workload as well, which is very doable. It is. You just need to manage your time. But everything is just so interesting here. Like, you have to love the course. There's no point in going somewhere that you don't love the course. And I love this course. And yeah, everything else is just a bonus. We have module tutorials every other week as well in this term. So a module tutorial, usually it'd be in person. You can do a little quiz and then discuss your answers with people. Obviously, we're not in person this term, so we're doing it on Teams. But we have to take a 12-question test, and then you get your mark at the end of it, and then you go to... We go on a Teams call and talk about the answers, and then there's a longer one as well where you can ask more in-depth questions if you want to. And I find them really useful. They're not formally assessed, so we'll get the mark, but it doesn't count towards our overall grade or anything. But it's good to know where you are, because I think that's very important. Because of the workload, you need to know what you do and don't understand. But my timetable this week, I just thought I'd give you a little run through. So this morning I had dissection on Teams, which I really enjoy. I think it's so good. Honestly, dissection's amazing. And you should definitely come to a dissection medical school. That's my recommendation anyway. And so I have another lecture to do today on cardiac pressure and volume, which is said to be quite a long lecture, so that's going to take a while. But I did... Yet tomorrow's lecture, because some of them are pre-recorded, on sleep apnea, which was really, really interesting. And there's so much application as well in this term. I didn't even realise, but literally every single lecture is on medical conditions and pathologies and diseases, which is just so good, because if you're anything like me, you do medicine because you want to go and treat patients and help patients. And that's why I love this course, because it is so focused on that. And yeah, I hope you have enjoyed this little week in the life video and it hasn't been too disjunct. But yeah, I love it at BSMS, and if I can give you any more advice, it would just be to really go with what feels right for you. If you want to be a doctor who really helps and understands their patients, then BSMS is the right place for you. Like, we have our symposiums with patients, we have all of this clinical teaching we do on Tuesdays, and it only gets better as you get older, into the older years. And it's just such a lovely medical school, but you've got to do what's right for you. If you have any more questions or anything, I'm sure you can contact the admissions department and they'll be happy to get you in contact with one of us. And yeah, I hope you have a great rest of your day, and maybe I'll see you next year on campus. Bye.